Good evening and welcome to St. Elizabeth's Eden. As we celebrate the 25th Sunday of Ordinary Time, I invite you to please stand and greet those around you. And let us now take a moment to quiet our hearts and minds so that we may greet the Lord who comes to us in this Mass. And our entrance hymn is Gather Us In on page 257.
Thank you. God, who founded all the commandments of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that, by keeping your precepts, we may merit to obtain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this, you who trample upon the needy and destroy the poor of the land. When will the new moon be over, you ask, that we may sell our grain, and the Sabbath, that we may display the wheat? We will diminish the ephah, add to the shekel, and fix our scales for cheating. We will buy the lowly for silver, and the poor for a pair of sandals. Even the refuse of the wheat we will sell. The Lord has sworn by the pride of Jacob, never will I forget a thing that they have done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Beloved, first of all, I ask that supplications, prayers, petitions, and thanksgivings be offered for everyone, for kings and for all in authority, that we may lead a quiet and tranquil life in all devotion and dignity. This is good and pleasing to God, our Savior, who wills everyone to be saved and to come to knowledge of the truth. For there is one God. There is also one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as ransom for all. This was the testimony of the proper time. For this I was appointed preacher and apostle. I am speaking the truth. I am not lying. Teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. It is my wish then that in every place the men should pray, lifting up holy hands without anger and argument. The word of the Lord.
He summoned him and said, "What is this I hear about you? Prepare a full account of your stewardship, because you can no longer be my steward." The steward said to himself, "What shall I do now that my master is taking the position of steward away from me? I am not strong enough to dig, and I'm ashamed to beg. I know what I shall do, that this, when I am removed from the stewardship, and how they will welcome me into their homes. This is what I shall do." He called in his master's debtors, one by one. To the first he said, "How much do you owe my master?" That person replied, 100 measures of olive oil." He said to him, "Here is your promissory note. Sit down quickly, write one for 50. Then to another the steward said, "And you, how much do you owe?" That one replied, 100 cores of wheat." The steward said to him, Here's your promissory note. Write one for 80. And the master commended that dishonest steward for acting prudently. Jesus went on to say, "For the children of this world are more prudent in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light. I tell you, make friends for yourself with dishonest wealth, so that when it fails, you may be welcome into eternal dwellings." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise the Lord Jesus Christ. This little parable that Jesus has brought forth today, trying to teach his disciples the importance of being consistent, of keeping one's word, you might say. And it seems it was always very confusing to me, because you have this guy who's in charge, the boss, the master. He has a steward, a servant that's working with him, kind of like an overseer of some of his vast holdings. And other persons in charge of making these notes and things. So he was kind of important, because he could reason and count and do a lot of things most people couldn't read and count in Jesus' day. So it's a key position. The master has great trust in him. And he's specialized for this. And what does he do? Now mind you, people in these positions would be getting part of the cut. It was normal. So it isn't like a salaried position or something like this. And they traded not only in money, but often it was in cattle, it was in wheat, it was in oil, it was a bartering system. And so this went back and forth all the time. So here this guy is cheating his master. The master finds out. And of course, what happened? He's fired. That was the nicest thing that the master could have done. That was the most lenient thing that the master could have done. He could have said something like, you know all that money, all that land, all those things? You're going to pay it back. You're going to go to jail, and it's going to be on the weight of your family. And if they don't pay by a certain time, as the law is prescribed, everyone's going to jail. And they won't get out until you paid every cent. So the master was very lenient with this servant. It's interesting. Very lenient. And then he goes on. The servant is thinking about himself, self-absorbed. And then he decided, well, it will take time for the news to get out that I'm fired. How can I save myself? I know I'll kind of deal with these people. They'll like the idea that they got a deal cut, and I'll kind of hide under their wings in safety. Well, what happens when these people find out the truth? And do you think the master's going to put up with that? If I told you someone stole from you, and now they're going to fraud you, you'd be like, oh, what a beautiful person. How delightful. The word the master is using there, he's very exuberant about the praise. The framing is that highly satisfied is how the translation would be in English and Greek word. Excellent. Let's see, you robbed me, you stole from me, and now you're committing a form of fraud. Excellent work, my employee. Now, I was very confused when I kept hearing this story because I said, it should have been thrown in the slammer. There should be great penalties about this. So what is Jesus getting at? My mind isn't grasping it. And that's because I was missing this central piece of a puzzle. This puzzle, you might say. The most important thing for the people of Jesus was not how much wealth you had, how much possessions, how much land, how much title. Many of the things that today we would consider important in our world, just to get through life, let alone capitalize on parts of life. No, the most important thing was honor. The worthiness of one's word. You know, America, we got off the gold standard years ago, and many countries for a long time, how much gold you got tucked away, gives you the ability to project your currency. Nowadays, we don't have enough money to back up in gold around the world, the American dollar. Why is it still working if we haven't got the backup? It's on the word of the American financial system, our integrity and openness. That's why all these little things going on with money are so important in this country, because ultimately there's a reputation that the dollar is the same, the commodity, the whole world. On the word of the American financial system. Imagine if it was unsafe. The dollar would fall. Do you remember the story of King Herod? King Herod was in charge of Israel at the time of Jesus Christ. And he himself, when Jesus came and began his public ministry with John the Baptist at the waters at the Jordan River, and then John was arrested for 3 years while Jesus proclaimed the word of God. Repent, turn back to God. John the Baptist was in jail. And King Herod would go visit John all the time in his private adultery, and the wife and the stepchild despised John the Baptist. But Herod kept them safe, challenged. But it's a good Jewish way to realize sometimes that's part of how it works. And what happened? John the Baptist died. A few weeks later, Jesus would die on the cross. What did Herod do? Herod put his word at risk. The honor that would plummet him literally overnight. He completely lose his confidence in the people and with all those around him in power and control. A little stepdaughter, young, teenage, beautiful, began dancing at a big party, and all the big wigs were there throughout Jerusalem. And there's Mary drinking too much. Oh, she's so beautiful. Oh, look at her dance. I'll give you whatever you want. Whatever you want. Half my kingdom, my dear. The phone goes to her mother and says, what should I ask for? The mother has the perfect answer. I want you to tell them that we want John the Baptist's head on a silver plate. And here's Herod doing this thing, and she comes in public saying, I have what it is. Everyone listen. He will grant me this wish. He has sworn by his name. And a few minutes later, whatever it took, came a platter with John the Baptist's head. As much as Herod did not want that, he had to save himself and his reputation. Jesus is known as the Word of God. The Word is the title of the Gospel of John for a very particular reason. Because God will never go back on his word. God will never lie to us. It is trustworthy always. And this is what Jesus is getting at with this steward and this little parable to this honest servant. And the leader, the king, the rich man, the owner, the master, he had a reputation. Imagine those who have saved on some of that money. If I could save you 20% on your housing mortgage, would you come back and deal with me again? You bring friends. And how happy are they? What ends up happening is that his honor increased so greatly in the eyes of those who the steward had changed the numbers and fixed the book, along with his reputation among all the people. And so what happened is his reputation grew. Those things that he had lost temporarily now would be won back tenfold. That's why he said, how wise, how very wise the body. And thus the story plays out now. How do we fit into this? Jesus says, take the dishonesty that is around us, in a sense, the money he's talking about as an article, not just dollar bills, but all the positions of power that might be there, and use them for the glory of God. Sometimes we try to wonder how to get into heaven. It's what we do here, but we're not perfect. Like the servant, sometimes we do our own things and agendas. We cheat God. But then when God really puts us on the spot, health crisis, death of a loved one, big emergencies, suddenly we remember who we are. And what do we do? We panic. We try to figure out what do we do. God has already forgiven us, but we have to do is embrace him for the good and generous master that he is, even if we are unworthy servants. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please rise, everyone. Let us now say together to you. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified by the Holy Spirit, he descended into hell, and is buried. We offer our prayers and supplications for everyone to our Lord, who is God in love for all his people. At this Mass, remember in a special way Daniel O'Sullivan and Lucille Billow.
For the Church, that we may be good stewards of the gifts that God has given us and use these to serve all of God's people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation's leaders and for all those in authority around the world, that the wisdom of God may guide all their decisions, and for all who serve in the military, that God will protect them in their services and bring them safely home to their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord. For the development of ethics and honesty in business, that all who lead companies may be guided by the Spirit to greater sincerity and justice in their work. Let us pray to the Lord. On this catechetical weekend, we pray for our catechists. May the Holy Spirit fill their hearts to go out and pass on the teachings and traditions of our faith to children and adults who strive to learn more about our faith and who are preparing to receive their sacraments. May God also guide us to support and love our catechists for the work and dedication that they put into their ministry. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are infirm of body or tormented in spirit, may find healing and peace in the Lord. We remember all those who are sick, especially for Mary Weissa, Dolores Peters, baby Benjamin Pirog, Mona Trapp, Richard Trapp, Maureen McCormick, Miriam Sandler, Wilda Skaggs, John DeLore, Michael Demo, Salvatore Gagliardi, and Evan Ragala. Let us pray to the Lord. For the souls in purgatory and all the faithful departed, that God may grant them eternal rest. We remember all the deceased members of our parish and our families, especially for Dorothy Considine, Anne Durkin, Pauline Mahula, and Meg Brett. Let us pray to the Lord.
Loving God, you gather us as one family around your table so that we may hear your stories of hope and share in the bread of life. May these gifts make us strong in faith and steadfast in love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
There will be two collections. They will be back to back. The second collection is for the seminary of people.
And as we share our gifts and prepare the altar, let us all sing together, Seek Ye First, number 309.
pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Our clergy. Remember also our sisters and that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And beloved, may the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
Amen.
Let us all offer to each other the sign of peace. Thank you. anyone is a catechist who works in religious education or any such programs, if they would come forward and give them a blessing, they would come right forward here along the stair line. Anyone here a catechist? Going once? Going twice? Well, in this case, blessings to all the catechists we know. Let us rise, everyone. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to profess and also possess your very redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our lives. Through Christ our Lord.